Hi, we're going to talk about low-emitting material that contribute to the indoor environment quality credit. The intention of this credit is to reduce concentration of chemical contaminants that can damage air quality, human health, productivity, and the environment. This credit is worth 1 to 3 points and can be applied to various building typologies. To achieve this credit, there are two options that can be employed. Option one is product category calculations. This is to achieve the threshold level of compliance with emission and content standards for a number of product categories. The materials can be broadly classified into 7 categories, which happen to be interior paints and coatings applied on site, interior adhesives and sealants applied on site, including flooring adhesive, flooring, composite wood, ceilings, walls, thermal and acoustic insulation, furniture, which is included in calculations if it is part of the scope of work, and exclusive to only healthcare and school projects, exterior applied products. This credit includes requirements for product manufacturing as well as project teams. It covers volatile organic compound emissions into indoor air and the VOC content of materials. Different materials must meet different requirements to be considered compliant for this credit. The interior and exterior of the building are organized into 7 categories with different thresholds of compliance. The building interior is defined as everything within the waterproofing membrane, and the exterior is everything outside the waterproofing membrane, inclusive of the primary and secondary weatherproofing systems. Option 2 is the budget calculation method. This method is employed if some of the products in a category do not meet the criteria. Points for percentage compliance under the budget calculation method on the basis of percentage are awarded points as seen in the table. The budget method is organized into 6 assemblies: flooring, ceiling, walls, where each layer is to include paint, coating, adhesives and sealants, thermal and acoustic insulations, which are tracked separately, furniture if it is included as part of the scope of work, and exterior applied products for healthcare and schools only. Total percentage compliance is an average of the percentage compliance of each of the assemblies. System percentage compliance is a total sum of the compliant area of different layers divided by the total surface area of the different layers into 100. Furniture systems are calculated using ANSI or BIFMA evaluation, as illustrated in the equation below. Here we shall talk about the emission and content requirements. Products that are inherently non-emitting sources of VOCs are considered fully compliant without any VOC emissions testing if they do not include integral organic-based surface coatings, binders, or sealants. Some examples for these kind of products are stone, ceramic, glass, concrete, etc. A general emissions evaluation must also be carried out so that building products can be tested and determined compliant in accordance with the California Department of Public Health Standard Method version 1.1 published in 2010. The default scenario that is used is a private office scenario. The manufacturers or third-party certification must state the exposure scenario used to determine the compliance. Claims of compliance for wet applied products must state the amount applied in mass per surface area. Manufacturers' claims of compliance with the above requirements must also state the range of total VOCs after 14 days or 336 hours, measured as specified in the CDPH standard method version 1.1. Projects outside the US may use products tested and deemed compliant in accordance with either the CDPH standard method or the German AGBB testing and evaluation scheme. If the applied testing method does not specify testing details for a product group for which the CDPH standard method does provide details, use the specifications in the CDPH standard method. US Projects, however, must follow the CBPH standard method. The VOC content requirements for wet applied products such as paints and coatings, adhesives and sealants must meet the applicable limits of the California Air Resources Board or the suggested control measure for architectural coatings or the South Coast Air Quality Management District, whichever is applicable. For projects outside the US, all paints, coatings, adhesives and sealants wet applied on site must meet either the technical requirements of the above regulations or comply with applicable national VOC control regulations. If the applicable regulation requires subtraction of exempt compounds, any content of intentionally added exempt compounds larger than 1% weight by mass must be disclosed. For projects in North America, methylene chloride and perchloroethylene may not be intentionally added in paints, coatings, adhesives, or sealants. Composite wood must have low formaldehyde emissions that meet the California Air Resources Board ATCM for formaldehyde requirements. For ultra-low emitting formaldehyde resins or no added formaldehyde resins, salvaged and reused architectural millwork more than 1 year old at the time of occupancy is considered compliant, provided it meets the requirements for any site-applied paints, coatings, adhesives, and sealants. Documentation submitted for furniture must indicate the modeling scenario used to determine compliance. Salvaged and reused furniture more than 1 year old at the time of use is considered compliant, provided it meets the requirements for any site-applied paints, coatings, adhesives, or sealants. With respect to healthcare and schools, additional insulation requirements would include BAT insulation products, which should not contain added formaldehyde. Exterior applied products must meet the VOC limits of the California Air Resources Board suggested control measure for architectural coating and the South Coast Air Quality Management District. Small containers of adhesives and sealants subject to state or federal consumer product VOC regulations are exempt. Projects outside North America may use either the jurisdictional VOC content requirements or comply with the European Decopaint Directive. Two materials that are prohibited and do not count towards total percentage compliance are hot mopped asphalt for roofing and coal tar sealants for parking lots and other paved surfaces. The intention behind this credit is to reduce the exposure to volatile organic compounds or VOCs. It has been observed that prolonged exposure to high concentrations of some VOCs has been linked to a wide range of chronic health problems. Short-term exposure to VOCs can also cause acute reactions such as eyes, nose, and throat irritation. VOC concentrations are typically higher indoors, where reduced air ventilation and numerous sources of VOCs may exist. Although completely eliminating exposure to all VOCs is impossible, specifying low-emitting and non-emitting products will significantly reduce the strength and quantity of VOC exposure indoors. Ideally, all interior building materials, from furniture and furnishings to thermal and acoustic insulation, and the interior finishes of all the floors, walls, and ceilings would be compliant. This credit uses a holistic systems approach that rewards teams for partial compliance, recognizing compliance of product assemblies even if some of their elements do not meet the applicable standard. This credit addresses each layer of wall, flooring, and ceiling interior finish, a methodology that is conservatively protective of occupants given that emissions from layers that are not directly exposed to air are tested separately. This credit still limits VOC for on-site wet applied products, in part to avoid environmental damage and in part to protect people who apply these products or are exposed to them during insulation. There are several steps to reduce the exposure to to volatile organic compounds. Step 1. Research and specify low or non-emitting finishes and furniture. The product is inherently non-emitting. Some examples are stone, ceramic, glass, concrete, etc. These do not include integral organic-based surface coatings, binders, or sealants. The manufacturer has self-declared the product's compliance and provides appropriate documentation as outlined in the credit requirements. The product has third-party certification of compliance. Step 2. Perform construction submittal reviews. During construction, coordinate a review of the construction submittals to ensure that selected products meet the credit requirements and do not exceed the allocated VOC emissions. Meeting these credit requirements is not typical for all construction teams and suppliers. Conducting a lead-specific pre-construction meeting to review the credit requirements in detail and stress their importance will aid in successful product procurement. Any product substitutions should be carefully reviewed by the design team and contractor for compliance with credit requirements. Some manufacturers have a list of lead compliant products on their website. Such lists are good resources for design teams and contractors to consult when sourcing products that may meet the requirements of this credit. Select one option. Based on the research performed and products purchased in each category identified in the credit requirements, determine which option is more appropriate for the project. Option 1 is simpler but less flexible, since partial credit in one category cannot be combined with partial credit in another category. If the minimum percentage compliance cannot be attained in a category, project teams must use option 2. Option 2 offers a budget calculation method that categorizes building interior products and materials into 6 assemblies. If at least 50% of an assembly is compliant, partial credit for that assembly can be combined with partial credit from another assembly to earn points, which ensures that the teams can receive partial credit for specifying compliant low-emitting products or materials in each assembly category if full compliance is not readily achievable. Option 2 may also allow the project to achieve more points and demonstrate higher overall compliance even if option 1 requirements are also feasible. The calculations can be categorized as under two options. Option 1 is product category calculations. Step 1 is to identify all applicable products. List all specified interior paints, coatings, adhesives, sealants, flooring, composite wood, ceilings, walls, thermal and acoustic insulation, and furniture as applicable to the project's scope of work. During construction submittal review process, obtain manufacturer documentation confirming compliance for each product category. The most effective way to track this credit is for one team member to keep a running list of products and their compliance information with manufacturer's documentation. Healthcare and school projects have an additional category, exterior products, that they may choose to pursue. Furniture is considered part of the scope if it is installed at the time of occupancy, regardless of who specified or provided it. Adhesives, sealants, paints, and coatings used on-site with flooring products are considered interior adhesives and sealants or interior paints and coatings as appropriate. The flooring itself must meet the requirements of the flooring product category. For wet applied product categories, 90% of the products must meet emissions criteria and 100% must meet VOC content criteria. To demonstrate the project's overall attainment of 100% of VOC content criteria, compare the baseline case and the design case in a VOC content budget. If the design level is less than the baseline, the credit requirement is satisfied. This table compares the baseline case and the design case. Step 2 is to perform the budget calculation method as necessary. A different budget may be used if threshold requirements cannot be achieved for the material categories specified in the credit requirements. That is, if 100% of the product category does not meet the requirements, use the budget calculation method in option 2. The second option is the budget calculation method. Step 1 is to identify assemblies. Break out assembly components for each category. For each product in an assembly, calculate the surface area for typical wall, ceiling, and floor areas. Identify products that are full spread, such as paint or carpet adhesive, according to the manufacturer's documentation for application. Calculate the total percentage compliance. Use equation 1 in the credit requirements to calculate the total percentage compliance. Generate takeoffs and review estimates from subcontractors to calculate the surface area for each product. Equations 2 and 3 may be required to generate values for equation 1. For assemblies, use the following guidelines. If all the layers of an assembly are compliant, the entire surface area counts. Not full spread, wet applied products are included in the definition of interior finish if they are installed on site. If some layers of an assembly are non-compliant, calculate the weighted average using equation 2. At least 50% of an assembly must be compliant to contribute to credit compliance. If less than 50% of the assembly is compliant, it counts as 0%. If 90% of the assembly meets the criteria, it counts as 100% compliant. If some furniture is non-compliant, calculate the percentage of compliance using equation 3. The reference standards are selected considering the following factors: leadership and scientific basis of target criteria necessary for market transformation, the rigor of standards, specificity, consistency, and repeatability across competing assessors, standard development process, proprietary business interest, open balanced consensus, market adoption, balanced with other factors but high enough to ensure credit success, harmonization with best practices, necessary for efficiency and economical application, naturally occurring materials and products that are made from inorganic material emit either very low or no VOCs. USGBC recognizes that such products do not need to undergo testing to prove they do not emit VOCs. For the purposes of this credit, untreated and unfinished solid wood flooring can be considered non-emitting, even though such flooring will likely emit some amount of formaldehyde naturally. This applies only to flooring materials, not to wood paneling or cabinetry. The testing standards used to determine the compliance of products are as follows. The CDPH standard method version 1.1. It uses chronic reference exposure levels established by the California Office of Environmental Health Hazard Assessment, which includes some of the most stringent criteria in use. This is used for emissions testing and requirements of all products and materials except for furniture. The CARB ATCM composite wood formaldehyde regulation. The credit uses California Air Resources Board's 93120 airborne toxic control measure for formaldehyde emissions from composite wood products. It provides a way to determine the compliance of composite wood materials used in products not covered by full VOC testing in other categories. ANSI or BIFMA standards incorporate important advances that include defining an emissions factor approach for compliance, refining the mathematical estimation procedures for non-measured time points, and adding specific, highly detailed surface area calculations to ensure consistency. International standards such as the German AGBB testing and evaluation scheme is a leading industry standard that can be used for this credit with some limitations. It does not represent a European consensus, but does share common attributes with several European counterparts. It addresses six times more individual VOC requirements than the CDPH standard, and it specifies TVOC and total semi-volatile organic compounds limit for all unregulated substances. The following are referenced mass VOC regulatory standards. The US regulatory system for adhesives and sealants captures a limited range of listed product categories and excludes small packages intended for consumer use. The leading CARB and SCAQMD regulations are well ahead of other state and national regulations. This credit includes requirements for all product categories found in the reference standards. Those that are not listed do not need to be tracked. Because of divergent regulatory development processes, the coating categories, category definitions, and VOC limits vary between CARB, SCM, and SCAQMD. Suppliers should provide information on the proper categorization of their materials consistent with the definitions in the reference regulations. Information on any VOC compounds exempt from regulation is required for credit compliance. Cited regulatory limits do not include the VOC content of colorants added to coatings at the point of sale. Pre-tinted flat, non-flat industrial maintenance coatings and stains include the VOC content of all ingredients include colorants. The following table can be referred to calculate the surface area for each layer in a building system. For all building systems listed in the table, salvaged and reused items more than 1 year old at a time of occupancy do not require testing. The rating system varies for different building typologies. In the case of core and shell, credit will be given for each product category installed in the core and shell of the building. In case of healthcare and schools, exterior applied adhesives, sealants, coatings, roofing, and waterproofing must meet the VOC limits of CARB, SCM, and SCAQMD. A list of all exterior applied materials and products used on site must be submitted. Hot mopped asphalt and coal tar sealants are prohibited. This is the total percentage compliance that needs to be met for healthcare and schools. It has been modified to account for exterior applied finishes. The required documentation are the USGBC low emitting materials calculator and the product information. In case of a campus, the buildings in the group can be documented as one. This is known as the group approach. However, each lead project must pursue the credit individually in case of a campus approach. Some related credit tips are the MR credit furniture and medical furnishings. This is applicable for healthcare only. The testing standards for option 2 of this related credit also meets this credit's testing standard requirements for furniture and furnishings products. The environmental quality credit, indoor air quality assessment. Using products with low emissions can significantly improve indoor air quality. Each product category pursued increases the chance of passing the indoor air quality testing limits for the related credit. We have reached the end of the presentation. Thank you.